Yes, I have.
21 years is a long time in one place.
Feel it is. I feel it's time to move on.
And you're at what age now?
I'm in my early 40s.
Exactly.
46.
Well, it's not necessarily a handicap. Well, it is, of course, you have to face that, but not necessarily a disabling handicap. Experience does count for something.
I would hope so.
Now, between ourselves, is there any trouble even using my leaving that with a parent form?
Nothing like that.
Like what?
Nothing at all.
No long-term understanding has come to a sudden end, making for an insupportable atmosphere?
I've always completely avoided anything like that at all.
No personality attachment with any of your immediate superiors or inferiors?
I've always taken care to get on very well with everyone.
I only ask because it can affect the reference. It also affects the motivation. I want to be quite clear why you move on. So I take it the job itself no longer satisfies you. Is it the money?
It's partly the money. It's not so much the money.
$9,000 is very respectable. Have you dependents?
No dependents. My mother died.
So why make a change?
Other people make changes.
But why are you, after spending most of your life in one place?
There you are. I've lived for that company. I've given my life, really, you could say, because I haven't had a great deal of social life. I've worked in the evenings, I haven't had office entanglements for the very reason you just mentioned. And if you're committed to your work, you don't move in many other circles. I had management status from the age of 27, and you'll appreciate what that means. I built a department, and there it is. It works extremely well. And yet, I feel I'm stuck there. I have watched younger men who I've trained go on in my company or elsewhere to higher things. Nobody notices me. I don't expect it. I don't attract attention to myself by making mistakes. Everybody just takes it for granted that my work is perfect. They will notice me when I'm gone. They will be sorry, I think, to lose me. They'll offer me more money, of course. I will refuse. They will realize when I'm gone what I was doing.
If they offer you more money, you won't stay?
No, I won't.
Are you the only woman?
Apart from the girls, of course, yes. There was one. She was my assistant. It was the only time I ever took on a young woman assistant. I don't care greatly for working with women. I feel I pass as a man in the workplace. But I did take on this young woman. Her qualifications were excellent, and she did well. She built up a department, and she left company for a competitor where she's now on the board, and good luck to her. She has a different style. She's a new kind of attractive, well-dressed. I don't mean I don't dress properly, of course, but there is a kind of woman who is 30 now. They're not so careful. They take themselves for granted. I have had to justify my existence every minute, and I have done so. I have proved. Well,
let's face it. Vacancies are going to be one, so you'll be in competition with younger men. There are companies out there that will value your experience enough, you'll be able to chance. There are also fields that are much easier for women. There's a cosmetic company here. It's 8.5. I don't know if that appeals.
I proved I can earn money. It's more important to get away.
Talk so much in an interview.
I don't. I don't normally talk about myself. I only talk to you now because it seems to me this is different. It's your job to understand me. Surely you ask the questions.
I think I understand you sufficiently.
Well, good. That's good.
Do you drink?
No, I don't drink. I'm not a teetotaler. I think it's very suspect to be a teetotal, seen as being an alcoholic. No, I don't drink. Why?
I drink.
I don't.
Good for you.